Hi, Rick, I'm the LinkedIn guy, and in today's video, I will demonstrate some of the advanced searches you can perform on LinkedIn and with the various filters. So from our homepage, let's click on the advanced tab up here near this search button. And when you click on that, you're going to get to a page that has a series of filters. It's called the advanced people search. Now, depending on whether you have the free or the paid version on LinkedIn, you will have access to fewer or more filters. I will discuss the differences in the filtering on the paid and the free in a different video. But for now, this is the screen that you are going to get, even if you have a free the free version. So a couple of things to notice. Over here on the left, you can do various searches by keywords, first name, last name, title, etc. So I am going to demonstrate the differences, because you can slice and dice the way you do searches on LinkedIn in many different ways. So the first thing I'm going to demonstrate is searching by keywords. This is similar to a Google search that you would put in and go over the entire internet. When you do keywords, it searches the entire LinkedIn database and profiles. So let's do a search for CEO. And I'm going to narrow it down under location. I'm going to narrow it down to 50 miles of a zip code here in San Diego. Okay, so I'm going to click on search, and that's the only thing I'm going to search for. I'm going to search. And you're going to see in a moment the results. There are 25,887 results for CEO within 50-mile radius of 92037. All right. Now, let me share with you. We're going to do the same search, but we're going to take the CEO keyword out of the keywords and put it under title. And we're going to make it current. See, you have several options when you do title. And we're going to make it current, and that should narrow it down a bit. These are CEOs that are current in their title within 50-mile radius. Everything remains the same, just we change from keywords in the entire profile to just within their title. And let's click on the search. And here you go. Instead of 25,000, it went down to 20,000. Okay, so that's about a 20% reduction by going doing the same keyword, but in a different location. All right, now let's do the same thing by adding a more complex search. We're going to do CEO, founder and CEO. Right, and we're going to do that. Everything else is the same in the title, and we're going to do it and see what do we get. So now we get narrowed down even further, because it went down from 20,000 to 3,300. So this person has founder and CEO somewhere in their title. All right. So that's another way to do it. And if we do the same search, okay, under keywords, we should also get a different result. Let's see what we get. And we get to 5,000. So you can see these are different ways, and you may want to go into the keywords versus titles for various reasons. So you can play around and see what is your objective. You can also do what people call Boolean searches, and those are complex searches that have some parameters. Let me do one that I have here. I'm going to do here in parentheses, if I can find. Okay, nope, wrong one. So C, chief executive officer. Okay, so what I'm doing here, let me show you. I'm doing chief executive officer. This is all in quotations. Okay, when you put something in quotations, it is looking for this exact phrase. So I'm looking, this is a very complex search, chief executive officer or CEO or president. What it's doing is it finds, does it have the words exactly like that? But it's multiple searches. And I'm also going to exclude several terms that I don't want by putting the word not. I don't want them to be visitor chairs, etc. Or, so this is a very complex Boolean search, and look at the results I'm going to get. All right, I'm going to get a much more targeted result. Okay, I got 154,000 because it contains many of the terms without some of the other ones. Okay, so it's just another way to slice and dice the data. If I narrow it down by 10 miles, you're going to see this number going down from 154,000 to 41,000. Okay, I can also do whether they're first, second, or third degree. So if I just wanted to do my first degree connections that had those terms, that's going to go down to 649. If I want to do second degree connections, but not first, let me take that. It did both, but I need to take the first one out. So I'll take the first one out. Now that number went up. So these are various ways that you can actually perform the searches with the various filters. And it's a very powerful tool that you can use to start getting to the people that you want to get inside of LinkedIn. I hope you found this video useful. If you have any questions, please reach out to me at thelinkedinguy@gmail.com. Enjoy an extraordinary day. Bye-bye.